look at the gate with the crown and the balls, you know, for the world domination. It's all there, you know, a lion, and you know, and here it even says Aquapark Isis. Yo, La Commanderie, that's a of the Templars, a stronghold of the Templars in France. It's called La Commanderie. So this is in Dole. I'm in Dole, D-O-L-E, next to Salins-les-Bains, where the other Templars were. It's a real stronghold here. It's really, yeah, if you look at all the images. And so this is another Jesuit chapel here. Looks horrible. And in Dole. So next to the other one. Jesuit ones in Salins-les-Bains. It's not very far. It's full of Jesuits here. It says Chapelle des Jesuites, Jesuits. Yeah. Now let's have a look at the other side. There's the sun hieroglyph here. And there's another Jesuit church here. The chapel. Well, it was a bit big for a chapel. It says Collège des Jesuites. It was a, so that means there was a like a school for them, you know. It's not very far from Switzerland, and next to the other place in Salins-les-Bains. Yeah. I'm gonna read it all in English here. Jesuits. Now you see, it looks a bit like a castle, but you know, the Jesuits have a general, which is the actual Pope, who said, well, you know, homos, it's okay, you know. And this is supposed to be a guy who believes in the creation of God. You can see this is Dole, this is the place here. And they even have a Place des Templiers, Halle des Templiers, Rue des Templiers, Commanderie. Ah, they've been here strong, all right. Here, it's the house of the Templars here. So this is official, you know. All sort of Templar stuff here. And there's a restaurant, it's 222. I don't know about it. It's probably a code of the Templars. It's like a little chateau, like, you know. Templar thing here as well. The Templar stuff. Now I'm going to show you the road and the of the Templars here. We're being watched all over. It's horrible here. Everywhere, you know. Now I'm back at this Templars restaurant here. And you know, if you're walking, you know, you think about things, you know. And then I suddenly, after having been to this Templars stronghold, I suddenly knew. And this is on the other side of the line, you know, going to there. So 222. If you think of three numbers, of course, you think of 666. Yeah. And 2 + 2 + 2 is a 6. And if you turn it around, you know, I turn it around. Is it difficult? Oh, it's still. The camera adjusts itself, but anyway, maybe if I do it like this, maybe you see it. But anyway, if you turn it around, what's up, it's down, and what's down, it's up. That's their law, isn't it? So, if you turn this thing around, you almost get a 6. Yeah, look here, this is a 6. So it does say 666, and of course you don't want to call your restaurant 666. And maybe like in the Middle Ages, they, you know, they, or you can write a 2 like an upside down 6, you know. So then again, here's this Templar stuff here, Maison du Templier. And I've never seen a town with so many cameras all over. Look at it, because this is still a stronghold. This is where they started, with where the Freemasons are. This is where it all is. So I'm here in the 222 restaurant, the 666 restaurant, and it was a chapel. Imagine a chapel with 666. You're being filmed everywhere inside, so, well, you don't really want to eat here. There's another camera, and another one. So you can see it was a chapel. Look at it. And this is an area where they like to, it is a chapel, you can see that. Interesting. So this was a Templar's chapel on the other side of the road going to the it even says Chapelle des Templiers. Look. Chapelle des Templiers. And here I got 4 times the 2. And that makes 8 octagon. So, and octagon is the number of the Templars. You know, so they got both here. They got the 666 here, and they got the octagon here. So now I understand. An octagon, you know, if you draw a line around the Templar's cross or a Swiss cross, you get an octagonal form. So this is octagon. That's why there's a 222. Yeah. Oh, fantastic. So this is their card of the Chapel of the Templars. It's a real Chapel of the Templars. In this place, it's called Dol. And this is, it's a code, you know, they gave it, it's a strange name for a restaurant, isn't it? Just four numbers. And outside it's three numbers. So yeah, it's a 666 outside, and their card inside, it's 2 + 2 + 2 + 2. It's 8, that's octagon. Well, guess who's gonna eat here? What kind of a six is this here? So this is the inside of the chapel as I filmed before. So this is their card. And they say that this means octagon is good. There you go. It's everywhere. Just look out, folks. The chapel of La Chapelle des Templiers. The chapel of the Templars. They're still there. You think they really left, you know? They go out and eat, you know, they're still there, everywhere in the world. And out of them came the Masons, and they're gonna eat here. Yeah, it's the real estate, Agence des Templiers, you know, the real estate of the Templars. And by a castle here. They're watching us again, here in Dol, it's horrible, they're watching us everywhere. Oh, what a place, man. So let's find the road of the Templars. It's all very aristocratic in this Templars place. Apparently this is a school, a college, you know, kids going in there, you know, it's all very aristocratic here in Dol. Look at it. All over. And they even have a big pyramid with a capstone here in Dol, you know, next to the city wall here. I'm getting out of here. I want to stay here. Place des Templiers, the square of the Templars. Oh, there it is. There's the road of the Templars. Let's go have a look. So this enormous place is called La Commanderie. The Commanderie in France is a stronghold of the Templars. So there's no doubt they were here, you know. If you see all the cameras here, I mean, they are the towns they do first, you know, their towns, you know, for the total control thing, you know, because they are the new world order. So here around it, you know, there's an old bridge here. So this enormous complex here, this is called La Commanderie, where they have concerts now, and you know, so still the place where it's all going on, like, you know, next to the river, of course, very strategical. And well, Freemasons, Templars, it's all here. So it already started with a Roman bridge, which is just behind here. Romans, it's the same thing, you know, it's all pharaohs. Yeah, you'll read it yourself. This is a stronghold, and this is the building again, you know. The Templar stronghold, this is what they call it, basically. The Templar stronghold. Music, concerts, and all that, you know. I'll show you the bridge, which is just behind here. So there's an old Roman bridge just mentioned here. I suppose people bathe here in the summer. It's a clean river. It's a beautiful area, really, in the east, northeast of France here. And there's the Templar stronghold again. Here it says Rue des Templiers, the road of the Templars. And look at the coat of arms of Dol, you know, the Sun Templars, you remember, in Switzerland, they killed them all. And white is here represented, you know, the White House is represented by gold. A lion, blue for the war crown, red for the original pharaohs in Lower Egypt, the Pertaser. Yeah. Actually, sometimes they make the red smaller because there are less of them, which are the first sons, the primogenitura, red. As white is more the older descendants, also the second and the third sons and everything. And this thing here, they call it, I think this is the one, the Hall of the Templars. See if I can find a shield for you. Well, there it says, the Hall of the Templars. So if anybody passing by, coming in here in Dole, this is called D-O-L-E, like being on the Dole, like, you know, parasiting on somebody else, well, that's what they did. Then they know the road over there is going to the Templar stronghold where Jacques de Molay was. So this is the way they organize as well, you know. I'm trying to find some sort of a Templar's stronghold here. But here, look, here's the stairway going up here. Shall I take it or not? What do you think? Oh, let's go. Oh, I can't resist that. So let's have a look. Where this is going to. I can get all the bushes here. Oh, it's quite old here. Next to Dole. Wonder where I get, hey? In there. I wonder if this is it, the Templar stronghold. I don't know. Could be. So here it is. The village is even called Le Temple. Even the founder of the Templars, Jacques de Molay. Here he is. Jacques de Molay. He was here, and it says that it is haunted. So I don't understand the coat of arms. What is it? And it's next to the second biggest forest in Europe. It's amazing here, really amazing. And Philippe Lebel, the King of France, it all says. I don't know how to film it like this. And the next line. No, I'll probably do it like this. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah. So, and it was built here during the Crusades, you know, 1132. 1291, very important date. Switzerland was founded and was the end of the Crusade. Very important date, you know, it's really... So here it is, behind the wall. Even the road is called Rue de la Commanderie. I went to the tourist information, well, they didn't know anything about it. So this is really, I think this is the most important place of the Templars. There's a nice river just there, where the trees end there, there's a nice river. And well, there it is, behind the bushes. So I'm gonna have a look. The octagon is here. And that's me. Pharaoh there, me here. And it says the people to whom it belongs now, it's Roland Gobert. Roland, typical aristocratic name. Monique Roy Gobert. Roy, you know, the king. So very aristocratic, you know. And here it says Chevalier, the knights, and Commanderie, that means the stronghold of the Templars, and it's in Falton, la commune de Falton, Saint-Denis le Temple, that's why it's called there, Saint-Denis le Temple, Les Doles. Yeah, the Order of Malta, it says. La Maison du Temple, yeah. So again, this is very, very important, you know. This is why we had two world wars as a transition from the old world order to the new world order. Terre des Templiers, the ground of the Templars. Terre des Mystères, L'Armeau du Temple. Oh yeah, it's haunted. They have strange animals like le vouivre, and it's haunted. Well, these guys were completely into black magic anyway, you know. So, well, let's have a look. Shall we go? Rue de la Tuilerie, you know. So that's where the king lived, I think, in his castle, La Tuilerie in Paris. Very important. So this is all next to it, you know. So here it is. I'm not sure if I can go in here. I think it's people are living here. So why is it haunted? You know, because like Freemasons do, you know, they do sacrifices, black magic, Satanism, as is still going on, especially in Switzerland today. That's why we had the satanic ritual on June the 1st, 2016. 2016. I didn't have any access on a computer, so I couldn't make any videos about it. This is very, very important here. And it's next to the other temple, in Salins-les-Bains, not very far. We even have a temple here, so they still have doing things here, you know. Of course, the Freemasons are gathering together here. It's very secluded here, you know. He looks like an Arab anyway, you know, like a assassin. Octagonal. Yes, it is. You see there, there's a big Templar's cross there. I don't know what they do with it. There. Behind it. I'm not sure if I want to go in. Well, at least not from this side. It looks still, I don't know. Even in the wall, here's a cross here. Look at it. Very important place. Even Jacques de Molay was here, the founder of the Templars. Yeah, just opposite the people, their name is Lacroix. Well, what do you guess, eh? What do you know? It's just opposite this thing here. The cross. People are being called the cross. Oh, there it is, the cross. It looks evil. It feels no good here. Yeah. So these people of the cross are just living next to it there. What does it say here? A lot of funny symbols. 1771. IHS. And a cross. Templars V. And it says Commanderie Temple du Temple. Commanderie du Temple. What does it say? 1174. 1132. Okay, 1132. I'm not sure this is old. Well, let's ring the bell then. Somebody told me some English are living here. Well, let's ring the bell. Okay. There you go. It's for attaching the horses. There's another one there. Yeah. This is interesting. It looks like the Vatican, doesn't it? Like the keyhole. Why do they make this form like this? They don't do anything like this, you know, without a reason. Like the Vatican, you know. There's the stables next to it. Well, even Jacques de Molay was here. So this is where the New World Order started, you know, just like the castle I filmed in the south and the temple next to it. They had a lot of stronghold, having contacts to each other. Well, I'm not getting in, you know, and there's nothing to see anyway. Maybe there is, but I don't feel like it. So here's the old Templar wall, going all the way around it. Let's see to the end where it goes to. You know, it's forbidden to get in. Private property, it even says danger. You know, they even dare to threaten us, you know, it's still the ones who are in power. Being here, so it's not this Lady Roy, and you know, which was on the shield. There's some English people, but of course it's all the same ones. So this is very, very important, and it seems like in the east of France, the northeast is a big stronghold of the Templars here, and of course Gréoux-les-Bains, the castle. And just behind it here is the river. Even the village is called Le Temple, commune de Falton, next to Dole, about 5 kilometers. Okay, and here's the sidearm of the river. Yeah. So there's again the stronghold of the Templars. And this road is going to Dole, exactly where is the Place of the Templiers, the Square of the Templars, the Rue des Templiers, the Road of the Templars, everything. Exactly where this road is going, it ends up where all this is. At the tourist information, they couldn't tell me a word about it. So you have to find it all out yourself, you know. They didn't even know, you know. Well, they didn't seem like they wanted to work, you know. They just wanted to get their money and don't work at all. So this road here is going exactly at that side of Dole, where immediately it ends up at the Road of the Templars and the Square of the Templars, and you know, well, this is the way they do it. And I saw somebody going in there. Let's have a look. So that door there is probably made new, but anyway, that was the entrance of the order. What do we see here? Looks a bit like a fleur. Yeah, it's a fleur de lis on both sides, of course. You see, here's a fleur de lis, and there's one, and in the middle. And a sort of a cross in the middle. Wow, fascinating. All these people still know what they're doing, even if it's new, you know. I should have a look, but I don't feel like climbing here through all the, you know, never mind. Very important here, very important. The founder of the Templars was here, Jacques de Molay. And these, I tell you again, these were the second and the third sons, and the fourth sons who wanted to rule as well. And this is why the French king, he arrested them all on Friday the 13th, or almost all. And he trialed them 7 years later in 1314. And 1307, when he arrested them, that was just 16 years after they already had founded Switzerland, so they were in safety. And they could prepare for the New World Order. This is where the New World Order started, partially, together with some other Templar sites, but this is a very important one. You can house a lot of guys in here, and the surroundings, even tents. Look, and there's the Well of the Templars. Another one probably next to it, or a grave. But that's the Well of the Templars. Yeah, and there he is. Here he is again, the Templar dude. Yeah. He looks like a Saracen to me. Very important. Just opposite this Templar stronghold. Probably noticed me hours before Templars there. So you see, I'm next to the Templars stronghold where I slept. Oh look, this is a safe. Somebody nicked a slave, tied it onto a rock, and dumped the rest in the lake here. Yeah, well, you see, it's all marshes. It's part of the river here. And on the other side is the biggest forest there. It starts there, of France. It goes for real big. It's the second largest not pine trees forest in France. And well, the Templars, the New World Order started in France. And why in the east of France? Why there's so much in the east? Because in the Middle Ages, it was all forest and swamps and mountains, nothing. The French kings, they were all in the west, you know, and in the south, more in the west, on the Loire River. So the primogeniture, the first sons, les dauphins, they were all in the west. So there was all forest, they could hide here, you know, and organize, and that's what they did, you know. It's still all forest here in the east of France, you know, it's unbelievable. You wouldn't say so, you know, if you think of France, you think of Paris and, you know, the Mediterranean beaches, Nice. Arabs in the sand in Nice. You know, but it's all forest. It's really more than anywhere else maybe in Europe this way, mountains and forests, and in Italy, to the north of Italy. So, yeah, and then they had to escape, and they went to Switzerland, where they realized the New World Order, and which is their base. So the New World Order started in France, and it got realized in Switzerland. And now the biggest military base is, of course, the United States, yeah, with all their obelisks and everywhere. But as you know, it all came, the American Revolution, it all came from France, you know, against the English king. So, but Switzerland still is the most important base where it's all, where these sort of things all are, you know. Well, it's funny, next to the Templars' stronghold, I find a safe, yeah, quite rusty, and it's tied onto a rock, as if it wouldn't sink by itself, you know. What would be needed to sink the other thing first, you know? Maybe it needs the safe to sink the rock with the rope on it, you know. These things are so incredibly heavy. So next to the Templar stronghold, the Templar's treasure, and, you know, Switzerland, the base of it all, where all the money is, I find this here. So I slept next to the Templar's stronghold last night. And these are all swamps next to the river. It's quite a big river. It's called Le Doubs, D-O-U-B-S. It's called Le Forêt de la Choux, the biggest forest in France and the second biggest non-pine tree forest. I forgot the name of it, you know, all these trees with leaves on it that fall in winter. I forgot the name. Well, it's this kind of forest. It's huge. You can walk in there, you know, for weeks and get lost. I see, here's the beginning of an immense forest. Well, here you won't see it even, but it's dense. This is only the beginning, you know, immense. So I think in these days, you know, that's why the New World Order, they kept their forests, because here they could organize in the east of France, just as they make a terrorist attack on Friday the 13th. You know, they want to be reminded of amongst each other, and, you know, and I've shown you now that the Templars really organized very strongly in the forest areas of the northeast of France. So then Switzerland wasn't very far anymore, and they just went over and made a holy, or rather unholy, alliance with the Swiss people, and mixed, breeded with them, you know, the Templars. So Switzerland, Suisse, they became the Sœurs d'Isis, the Sisters of Isis. You know, as their descendants, you know, what came out of it, the Freemasons, they all show this sort of Isis things, the whole pharaonic, I don't want to utter that word. Yeah, so east of France, it's an incredible, large, big, huge forest, and it starts right there where this Templar thing is, you know, the Templar stronghold. So for me, there's no doubt at all that they keep it like this. There's probably a lot of things here. And a lot of hideouts in this forest, and they want to keep it like that, yeah? I mean, they got all the power to do so, and they say, well, we want to keep a forest somewhere, a big one, for the animals and all that, so we can go hunting. And actually, in the east of France, you know, the Frenchies, they don't even have money to pay 1,000 euros a year, you know, to go hunting. So it's all Swiss hunting in France, and they're Templars. So nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. They got the dough, they come hunting. I've been talking with French hunters, they told me that. So, the French kings, they were mostly in the west of France, on the Loire River, where all the castles are. And the Templars were mostly hiding in the east and in the south of France, in the northeast, where they finally ended up, and they crossed the border to Switzerland. Well, there still is a natural border, the Rhine, and, you know, the mountains really start there, you know, so it's a really fantastic stronghold, you know.
and they had to make an alliance with Swissy, you know, and they did. And then they killed the gypsies, the Jews, they killed the 28 million Russians, and it goes on and it goes on. Now it's the Arabs' turn. The Turks will be next. I tell you, they will be next. Erdogan is one of them. Oh yeah. Oh, here it says, there's some, well, let's have a look what it says. So this just part of this huge forest. It's a section of it. And it's much larger. And this is the only road, you know, in it. Otherwise, afterwards, there are no more roads at all. So I don't even want to be there much longer. So, yeah. Good. So this is another, you know, another point, you know, that the Templars concentrated so much, you know, before they here in the south, in the large forest and swamps areas, and mountain areas in the northeast of France, in the Jura and the Franche-Comté, Alsace, and especially here. And before they crossed over to Switzerland. So we can just follow the road, the itinerary where they, how they did it, how it all went, you know. Very important. This is very important. And I in Salins-les-Bains, I really saw that there is a real big stronghold. There was a big stronghold in those days, and there still is, of the Masons, before they crossed over. So here we can see the itinerary of the Templars, who brought the New World Order and who are aristocrats. Okay, let's go on. I still have to walk a long way through marshes and large forest areas. So I think I'm going to take this road up here, this path here. You remember the Cajun people and their lovely Cajun music and the Mississippi Delta and all that, and who are of French descent, New Orleans, it's Nouveau Orléans, it's French, you know. Orléans was also where the king was living, so he gave the name, you know. But anyway, it's from the word Cajun, Cadien, they call themselves Cadien. And they're probably the toughest people in the entire United States, the way they're living, and well, you can see it, you know. Tougher than the Texas Rangers. Well, they're mostly Swiss, like Alex Jones, yeah. Tougher than the real hillbillies. These guys here are tough as nails, and they still live like this here, you know. It's like Cajun part, country here. Look, it's like Mississippi. They're all fishing here and hunting and you know, forests, lakes, river, water. Cold. It's very cold here. It gets colder here than in Scandinavia, I think. Because we are in the south of Scandinavia, it's a lot of sea climates, you know, but here it's get real cold. It's mountainous, it's a land climate. So this is like Cajun people here, really. The toughest nails. Not like you imagine a French, like, you know, like a puff bastard from Paris, you know, a macho guy from the Mediterranean. Oh no, this is different here. Absolutely different. And yeah, wow, okie dokie, that's enough. Yeah, of course I meant Louisiana, that's where the that's probably the toughest Yanks you can get, and they are French origin, you know, the guys who can survive and, you know, and eating snakes and crocs, and well, there are no crocs here, fortunately, but this is where they get from, and they call it Louisiana because of the French King Louis. We call it New Orleans because Nouveau Orléans, that's where he was living. Yeah. Right. So it's like Louisiana. It's just slightly bit colder. There's the other place yesterday where I tried to sneak in like there through the arches there. I think it was there. Yeah. Actually, these guys here, they have a saying in this area. It's like this. It's old French. It's Compte-toi, rends-toi, nuni ma foi. And it means compte-toi, this is the area here. It means you can give up and surrender. Yeah, you can surrender. But don't give up your willpower. It's like what I did, you know, I got imprisoned by the Swiss, but they didn't get my willpower. I'm still here. Hey, Swissy! Interesting, the word Cajun, it came back into French like Cajun, but it's from the English, you know, English word Cajun. But they call themselves Cadien, actually. And the word Canadien, it's from there. They also call themselves Cadien. So the word Canada is actually from Louisiana, which is probably from here. Well, that's it. So I hear this road going to this Templar stronghold. It's called Rue de la Résistance. Now I know what they mean. It's not the Second World War, the Resistance Road. It's the resistance by the Templars, of course, who made the Second World War. And this is the road going there. And on the other side is the Templar Road, the Templars' place, all the commandery. Well, yeah, there you go. On the other side, still next to it, like the Resistance Road, you know, there's Pharaoh. Yeah, there he is. It's all Pharaonic Templars. And this is the Grail. That means our blood is here, our descendants is here. Sort of a castle, I don't know what. Probably more to see. What does it say? MS? Yeah. Interesting. So there's the road to the Templar stronghold.